6 things that if you do, I promise, I give you my word, you'll be an instant bang of a poultry farmer. Let's roll. Number one, be financially prepared. Of course, that was very obvious. Now, by talking about being financially prepared, we are not talking about having too much money, like, you know, going and robbing a bank or having millions of dollars. No, what we mean is if there is need for something like money, you should have it. Let me give you an example. If you're starting a poultry farm or if you're running a poultry farm, at some point some birds could fall sick. Yeah. And if the birds fall sick, or if one bird falls sick, you need to be able to identify what's wrong with that one bird and treat it. Because if you don't treat it before time, you risk passing on the illness to other birds. I've talked about financial freedom or financial ability while starting a poultry farm in very many videos on my YouTube channel. And I think it's very wise that you should check them out. But guys, starting a poultry farm and running a poultry farm is not very, very cheap. That's true. You're going to need to buy the feeds. You're going to need to buy vaccines. You're going to need to buy very, very many things. And like I said, you don't need to have too much money. No, you just need to plan. Guys, if you have planned and you know what you're going to need to use money for and what you're not going to need to use money for, and you're ready in some way, you know, you have some money put aside in case any emergency arises on the farm, most likely, trust me, money could solve it. I think the Bible says money answereth all things. Yeah, I do believe that. If you have a problem on the farm, most likely money is going to be able to solve it. Of course, it might not be able to solve some diseases like Newcastle disease or things like that. But if you're financially prepared, trust me, you're very high chances of succeeding in poultry farming. Number two, ability to identify sick birds. Guys, this is very, very, very important because some diseases very easily spread from one bird to another. An example is Newcastle disease, but diseases like coryza. If you can very easily identify a sick bird, put it aside, separate it from the rest of the birds, you're going to be able to avert diseases on your poultry farm. So I think every poultry farmer should kind of have some information about poultry diseases. You should be able to identify a sick bird. You should be able to identify, you know, a bird that's not doing well, a bird that's not healthy, because it's, and guys, it's not hard. It's really not hard at all. While I started out in poultry, I didn't know any of these things. Right now, I'm almost an expert. Yeah, I'm almost an expert in even poultry diseases. I think it helps that I have a medical background. But guys, I'm almost an expert at poultry diseases and I didn't study any of these diseases. So you just, you know, go to the internet, read books, open books, read as much as you can, get this knowledge exposed to your brain. That way you're going to have very, very high chances of succeeding, because you know the biggest problem, or one of the biggest problems that farmers have in poultry farming? Diseases. Guys, I know in some countries like the US or in Europe, diseases are not a trouble. They have never been a trouble. For us here in Africa, in Uganda, I think like poultry disease is endemic. Guys, I don't know if you can see, I brought the geese onto the ponds. Yeah, it's been like a week that the geese are on these ponds and they are loving it. I decided to first take them away from my farm, bring them here, because from what I know, they have better chances of breeding quicker when they have more water around and all this kind of stuff. So they're enjoying themselves. I'll take them back to my farm. Or if you don't know, I'm not on my farm currently. This is my uncle's farm. And yeah, but I occasionally pass by here, you know, to help, check out a few things, just enjoying the birds and everything, because my farm is not far away from here. So, you know, I could easily slope down here. So as you can see, the kids are really, really enjoying themselves. Natural swimmers. But back to the diseases. Diseases are the most terrible thing that poultry farmers deal with. They cause the biggest losses in farming, in poultry farming. And if you can avert them, find ways of preventing them, know how they present, know even just a little bit of the treatment, trust me, you have very, very high chances of becoming a bang right on your first project. By the way, I'm Dr. Daniel, a practicing medical doctor who became a bang in poultry farming at my very first take. So I'm telling you from experience. I'm telling you these things from experience. It's what I've experienced on my farm. And I know you can do it. I don't think it was some miracle. I don't think, you know, some spirits fell upon me and I was able to figure out how this thing is done. No, I just did the right things the very first time. And I do believe you too can do that. So just in case you haven't subscribed to the channel, please don't forget to hit the subscribe button, hit the notification bell. That way you never miss out on an upload. Number three, proper spacing of the bites. Now, of course, if you're on a farm like this, which is like, you know, a free-range farm, that doesn't really matter. I don't know if you guys can see. Right in the background there, we have some turkeys, we have chickens, we have ducks, you know, moving. I think there are chickens right here that you can see. We have the ducks here, we have the geese right here. So this is a more integrated free-range style of farm. But if you're going to be doing deep litter farming, especially, the spacing is very, very important. Why is the spacing important? Have you guys heard of cannibalism? Like the birds just feed on each other. I know it's terrible, but trust me guys, the birds can feed on each other. They start pecking each other's feathers, they feed on each other's cloaca. And then poor spacing, you know, putting too many birds in one space, can also lead to unnecessary competition among the birds. And what does that lead to? Stress. Serious stress. So if you're keeping layers, the birds are not going to lay the eggs that you expect them to lay. And if you're keeping broilers, they're not going to gain the weight that they're supposed to gain, even if you're giving them the exact amount of feeds that they need, you know. The stress will be too much. Or some birds are generally, are naturally weak, you know. All of us are different, you know. There are some people I can't beat. I can beat very few people in this on this planet, you know, physically, with my energy. Because we are generally all made differently. I'm not physically like super strong. I'm probably not the fastest runner. There are people who are faster than me. Same thing with the chickens, you know, they naturally have different abilities. But if you give them the space and you provide them with everything that they need, they're able to compete with everyone else. But if you, you know, put them in a very small, tiny space, they're going to have too much competition amongst them. And what that's going to inevitably lead to is poor production on your poultry farm. So I know the temptation could come, you know, the temptation could arise and you want to keep too many birds, but you don't want to build a very big chicken house, you know, you're trying to save. Guys, don't try cutting such shortcuts, because in the end, you end up paying. You end up paying. Number four, poor hygiene on your poultry farm. Guys, if your poultry farm is going to be terribly hygienic, what do you expect? Diseases. And what do diseases come along with? Poor production, losses, death. Just look at the pandemic we are in right now. Diseases. Diseases are just terrible. So guys, proper hygiene is very, very important on your poultry farm. And it's not hard to keep proper hygiene on a poultry farm, yeah? Especially inside the chicken barn. Number one, put litter. Put the right amount of litter in the chicken house. The correct type of litter and the correct amount of litter. At least 6 inches deep. Very, very important. Don't try to cut shortcuts. If you do this, you're very probably going to maintain the hygiene, you know. Also turning the litter once in a while. That's what I've been doing, you know, on my poultry farm. Actually, I've talked about litter management on this YouTube channel before. I'll just leave a link right here. So, and along with hygiene comes number five, aeration. Guys, aeration is so important in poultry. I feel like it's underemphasized. Aeration is so important on a poultry farm. The other day I was talking to a friend and she was, you know, brooding her chickens from a garage, like a complete garage, and she was going to keep them there for weeks. Guys, what do you expect? Those birds inevitably are going to suffer from respiratory illnesses. Yeah, I know that you want to keep the birds warm and you don't want to spend lots of money on things like charcoal, on things like, you know, electricity, but you're doing that at the expense of other things, yeah? The aeration inside your farm is so super important, yeah? Let the walls, you must have at least 4 feet of aeration from top to bottom on two sides, all the way, you know? Very, very important. You do that, the chances of you becoming a bang immediately are so high. And then finally, not giving the birds proper nutrition or the right feeds. And guys, this is also very important. We know that chicken feeds are like the most expensive thing when it comes to poultry farming. Yeah, you're going to spend most of your money, if not all of your money, on the feeds. Yeah. So very many of us try to cut shortcuts. You know, you try to cut shortcuts, buy terrible feeds, buy feeds that are not like very, very good. Guys, you're going to lose when it comes to the production. Whether it's broilers, whether it's layers, whether it's dual purpose birds, whether it is, you know, ducks just like this. Yeah. Don't cut shortcuts with the feed. Of course, the system that you're going to be using to keep the birds will very largely impact how you keep the birds. Let me give you an example. You see these ducks over here? Over there, there is a feeder, yeah? And the ducks are feeding from a feeder. And that feed is not like super hyper nutritious. It doesn't have lots of protein. It's mainly carbohydrate, you know? But why can we afford to do that? Because these ducks are free-ranged, you know? They're going to scratch inside the mud around this area. I don't know if you guys can see, but we have mud right here, you know? We have mud right here. And inside that mud, the ducks will move in there, scratch, pick out earthworms, pick out, you know, everything that they can eat right from the soil. In the soil itself, they're going to be eating some of the soil, picking up nutrients from the soil. The water they drink, this water is from the earth. It has lots of nutrients, yeah? Unlike birds which are kept intensively on a poultry farm or something like that. So the system that you're going to be using to keep your birds will kind of determine what feeds you give the birds. And again, you don't need to spend too much money on chicken feed, yeah? I don't know if you guys have been following my channel, but I'm trying out very many different types of chicken feed. Actually, I'm going to be giving you guys an update about my black soldier fly farming very soon. It's going on quite well, so I'll be giving you guys an update. But you can do very many things, guys, yeah? You can use fodder, you can use black soldier flies. The important thing is good nutrition for your birds. So, proper nutrition, very high chances of you becoming a bang. And yeah, guys, that was it. Those were my 6 hacks, yeah, for you to become an instant bang while starting out on a poultry farm. Very easy to do. Just, you know, keep to the rules. Follow the rules and you're very likely to shine. Thanks for watching, guys. Don't forget to subscribe, hit the notification bell, and see you next time with another video. Lots of love.